Thank you, everyone, and I hope you enjoy this conversation just as much as I do. So thank you, all colleagues. I am Arielle Denis, International Peace Bureau consultant, and I'm going briefly to present you the treaty on the prohibition of nuclear weapons. So first, before I speak about nuclear weapons, I always like to start with what they are, and just to have that in mind that these weapons are the most destructive, inhuman, and indiscriminate weapon ever created. And in the scale of devastation, they cause a genetically persistent, damaging radioactive fallout. And they are really unique weapons, as a single bomb could kill more than 1 million people in a matter of seconds if it was detonated over a big city. So, as it was said before, times are worrying. Nuclear-armed Pakistan and India have engaged in armed conflict, while the United States and Russia have decided to quit the INF Treaty. And as you know, nuclear weapon states are improving their arsenals to be more destructive. And we can really feel that a new nuclear arms race is going to take place. So, of course, the need to act is important. And the humanitarian impact of nuclear weapons that I've just recalled is the core incentive of what brought 135 states to negotiate the treaty on the prohibition of nuclear weapons. The treaty was finalized and adopted by 120 states in July 2017. And it really broke years of passivity and changed the passivity of the states, not civil society. And it changed the landscape in nuclear disarmament. The TPNW also fills a significant gap in international law, as nuclear weapons were the only weapons of mass destruction not being prohibited. So what is the treaty about? So the treaty prohibits nations from developing, testing, producing, manufacturing, transferring, possessing, stockpiling, using, or threatening to use, that it was said by, I think, by John, nuclear weapons. Or, of course, allowing nuclear weapons to be stationed on their territory. It is the only treaty that does that. It also prohibits them from assisting, encouraging, or inducing anyone to engage in these activities. A nation that possesses nuclear weapons may join the treaty so long as it agrees to destroy them in accordance with a legally binding, time-bound plan. This plan can be negotiated before joining the treaty or in joining the treaty. Similarly, a nation that hosts another nation's nuclear weapons on its territory may join the treaty so long as it agrees to remove them by a specified deadline. So nations are obliged to provide assistance to all victims of the use and testing of nuclear weapons and to take measures for the remediation of contaminated environments. The preamble acknowledges the harm suffered as a result of nuclear weapons, including the disproportionate impact on women and girls and on indigenous peoples around the world. So it is permanent in nature, the treaty, and it will be legally binding on those nations that join it. So at the moment, 22 states have signed and ratified the TPNW, while further 70 states are signatories. The treaty itself is shaking the whole nuclear disarmament landscape, and the umbrella states are under pressure in many countries. It is really, as it has been said before, a great tool for civil society advocacy work. So to encourage us, I will say that the TPNW is the quickest of all the WMD treaty in terms of signature and ratification. It needs the ratification of 50 states to enter into force. So the pressure on nuclear weapon states is strengthening while the world is declaring nuclear weapons illegal, inhumane, illegitimate, that they are no right hands for these wrong weapons, and that the only way to prevent a catastrophe is to eliminate them completely. The TPNW greatly strengthens all the previous disarmament treaties, such as the NPT, which specifically envisages the creation of additional treaties to help achieve and maintain a nuclear weapons-free world. And the TPNW can play a key role, especially in the implementation of Article 6 of the NPT. So, to conclude, I said that the TPNW is a great achievement of a joint work of governments, international organizations, and civil society. It shows that international law can move even without the big powers, and it is an act of global democracy and resistance from the South. It is also unique in the way it emphasizes environmental remediation, victim assistance, and how it cares for people. So before being eliminated, all weapons have been prohibited. So the TPNW should be the basis for moving forward on nuclear disarmament. Thank you.